Welcome back to another video. I'm Altopoli, and today we're gonna keep on working on our PyCord Discord bot. Let's go ahead and start. So, in this video, we'll be working with cogs. So, let's create another folder called cogs. And in this folder, we wanna create another cog. We'll call it moderation.py. In here, we want to import all the necessary modules, Discord, and bridge. So here, we're gonna make our, we're gonna start making the cog now. So, in here, we'll create a new class, will be, oh wait, we forgot something, import bridge commands we want it for. So here, class moderation. Commands.cog, and then we want to define init def init self bot, then self.bot equals bot. Then we want to go ahead and create a new command, bridge.bridge command description equals do kick people. Then I want to check so the one that runs the command has permissions to kick members. So kick members equals to true. Then async def kick self context user discord.user, and then reason we'll have it as default as no reason provided. Then, if user dot guild permissions dot administrator equals 2, then return await ctx dot respond, you can't kick another admin. Otherwise, we're gonna try to await cdx.guild.ban user for reason equals to reason. And then we're gonna create an embed. Embed equals to discord.embed embed title equals to kicked description equals to you have been kicked from cdx.guild. And want the color to be discord.color. I don't know if this is a thing, red. Let's hope it is. Or we'll just do this. Equals to discord.color.red, and then await ctx.respond successfully kicked user dot mention for reason. And then we also want to try to send the user the embed. Await user.send embed equals to embed. Except pass. We'll just ignore that other way. And here, accept exception as e. Await ctx dot respond unable to kick the member. That's basically it. Let's just copy this command now. We'll make a ban command as well. We just need to change a few stuff in here. Here we'll just ban people. In here it's the permissions permissions. Ban members. And we want to call the command ban. Use for reason. Can't ban. Oh, I wrote wrong there. Okay, it should be. Banned. 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 There we go. Now, we can also create a... No, we'll... Yeah, we can actually do that. We'll create a purge command. Bridge dot bridge command description equals to delete messages. We'll be able to choose to delete messages from a certain user here, or just messages in general. Command dot has permissions manage messages equals to true. Async def purge self ctx amount, which will be an integer, from member discord dot member equals to none, so you don't have to pass that. If member is not equal to none, we'll do this msg equals to that, and async for m in ctx.channel.history. If len msg equals to amount break. Oops. If m.author.id equals to member dot id msg dot append m, and await ctx dot channel dot delete messages msg, await ctx dot respond messages from member has been purged. So, and return. Otherwise, if the member is not none, we'll just do await ctx dot respond will make it ephemeral purging messages. And ephemeral means that only you can see it. Ephemeral equals to true. Then amount plus equals to one. Oh no. Not when it is ephemeral. Await ctx.channel.purge limit equals to amount. Now we need to can also make a timeout command, actually. A simple one. Bridge dot bridge command description time out another member at commands dot has permissions moderate members equals to true async def timeout self ctx member discord dot member and minutes integer. We'll just do minutes for now, and duration will be time delta. We need to import time delta, of course. Minutes equals to minutes. Await member dot time out for duration. Await ctx dot respond. So successfully timed out member for minutes. There. And we want to make that ephemeral. Then we can also create an embed. Discord.embed. Title equals to timed out. Description equals to you have been timed out for minutes in cdx.guild. Make an F string. And then color equals to discord.color.red. If that's the thing. Then try await member.send embed equals to embed. Accept pass. There we go. And we'll want to make an unmute command as well, because that can be a bit good to have if you have a mute command. Bridge command. Description equals to unmute a member. Add commands dot has permissions. Moderate members equals to true. Async def unmute self ctx member discord dot member. Then we want to try and await member dot remove timeout and await cdx dot respond successfully removed timeout from member ephemeral equals to true. Make that an F string. If the member doesn't have a timeout, just do accept await cdx.respond failed to remove timeout from member. This could be because possible reasons for this could be that the member isn't timed out. Ephemeral equals to true. And then we also want to send an embed to the user. Embed equals to discord.embed. Title equals to timeout removed. Description equals to you have been unmuted in cdx.guild, and let's make that an F string too. Let's set the color to green. Color equals to discord.color.green. There we go. Now we just want to set up this cog now. We'll do for that. Def setup bot bot.add cog moderation. Bot. And then we want to save that up, go into the main.py file and do this. We want to first of all add to the client of one token as we forgot earlier. Then client.load extension. And then it will be cog/moderation.py. I believe, let me just double check this. No. Cogs dot moderation and not dot py. There we go. Now it should work fine. Let's upload this code. Add that cogs, not sigs, added cogs. Now let's commit that to main. Push the origin. Let's see if the bot is still online. Yes, it is. That's good. And let's just go in here and restart the bot. It should pull the new code from GitHub. Yes, it is. Of course. Please change or stash them very much. Okay, let's just do this. Let's recycle the file. And let's restart it. There. We now have a cogs folder and a main.py folder. And a main.py file. There we go. Logged in a severe bot. Now we have it online. Let's try ping. Let's try time out. Let's time me out for 10 minutes. Ah, right. Time delta isn't defined. Forgot about that. So we want to. We want to do. From date time import time delta. We can also import time. There we go. Let's commit this to main. Push the origin and restart the bot. Should update the file. There we go. It should work now. The bot is coming online. There we go. Let's do timeout now. Mark for 10 minutes. And why isn't this? Of course, yeah, missing permissions. We need an error handler later on. Let's try timeout severe bot 10 minutes. That shouldn't work either. Nope. So let's switch to your other account. Let's invite that account. There we go. Let's join the server. There we go. Here I am. Then let's go over here. No. Let's go over there. Try timeout Urbanoi for 10 minutes. There we go, successfully timed at Urbanoi for 10 minutes. There we go. It has a Urbanoi has a timeout now, we can see. There. Now let's try the unmute command. Unmute Urbanoi. Successfully remove timeout. There we go. Let's try to kick Urbanoi as well for reason. Aha, there we go. There we go. It works perfectly fine. Let's switch to Urbanoi and see if we got the message. There we go. Okay. Seems like... Alright, that's for the timeout. Seems like we gotta do this for the kick and ban. We want... Okay, no. That doesn't matter. But yeah, we now have a working moderation cog. Let's just try the purge command real quick as well. See if that works. Purge 1. There we go. Let's see if we can purge 2 from Let's just do 1, 2, 3. Purge 2 from SevierBot, and it should purge these two. No, it didn't. Crap. Uh, Anyways, we'll get to that in the next video. Thank you guys for watching, and have a nice day. Goodbye.